I have so much I should be doing right now. I have a content list this long and this long, yet just then I had the idea, hey, let's make another video that I hadn't planned, just spur of the moment, spontaneous Photoshop tutorial. And because I've been working with a lot of 360 photos lately, I thought it'd be really handy for you guys to learn the best 360 photo editing tips inside of Adobe Premiere CC 2018 that will save you a ton of time. So let's get into it right now. Traditionally, when you edit 360 photos inside of Photoshop, they produce all kinds of errors when editing the stretched out equirectangular 2x1 photo. And that is bad. So there's a way of editing your photos that will make your changes look native within that 360 environment, and it doesn't take long at all. So I've opened up a raw photo from the Mi Sphere here inside of Photoshop, and here's what it looks like. It's looking flat, but just you wait, I'm gonna edit this in Adobe Camera Raw and really bring out its potential. This is one massive benefit of shooting raw. You can really retain your highlights nicely, get your shadows looking how they should be, and get a really well-balanced image that couldn't have been possible when shooting in normal JPEG mode. All right, that is looking so good. So I'm gonna go ahead and open image now, which is going to open in the main Photoshop window. So we see the changes have been made and that dynamic range is looking so good. So to view this photo in 360 mode, you want to go up to 3D and choose the spherical panorama option and new panorama layer from selected layer. This now brings us into a 3D 360 workspace where we can look around our photo like that. And when you use the arrow, it pans around as you please. The first thing I want to fix about this image is the nadir. And you can see the Mi Sphere's tripod there. It looks ugly. I want that out of my photo. So the first thing I'm going to do is change my field of view, which you can find on the right-hand side in the properties. And we want to hit one, and that will zoom out so we can properly see our nadir. Now you edit the photo like you would a normal photo. So I'm going to choose the spot healing brush, and I'm just going to paint this bad boy out. Bye-bye tripod, it was nice knowing you. Now when we select the arrow again and we zoom up, we can see we're still in 360 mode and our tripod is gone. Next, let's add some text to our image so it shows up naturally within the 360 space. So I'm gonna write, Ben is the best. And we'll make that nice and big just in case there's any confusion. Let's have it right there in the sky. Great, we go apply. So while that has worked, when we select our background layer and move around, it stays in the same spot. So what we want to do is merge that text layer to the 360 photo. Do that by selecting your text layer, go to layer and merge down. So that now combines it with our 360 photo. You don't want to go merge all because then that will remove the 360 properties, but you want to go merge down. So now when we look around, see, Ben is the best stays there within the 360 space and it adjusts as you pan around. Excellent. Next, I want to add a graphic. I'm going to add the Photoshop logo in my hands so I can use this as my thumbnail. So I'm going to drag in the Photoshop icon there, and why don't we place it right there within my hands. All right, that looks good. So again, if we select our background layer and pan around, it's going to stay in the same spot, which is why we need to do the same thing again and select our graphic. And we'll go layer, merge down. So now, when we look around, see how the image now moves around within the 360 space. As it should, it doesn't stay in the middle, and it doesn't warp either. It stays nice and square. While we're in the 360 space, you can access a lot of the same tools as you might use if you're editing a normal photo. So I'm using the eraser here. Say you want to get rid of these wheels, for whatever reason, want to add white wheels to these cars, you can do that. And if you want to change your perspective, again, you need to change back to the arrow. And just for fun, why don't we do a drawing? I'm going to select my brush tool. I'll make it look like I'm doing a fart of fire. That would be pretty funny. Okay, done. Now again, when we go back to our arrow, everything moves as it should within the 360 space. You can see the perspective of that drawing I just did. It moves as I pan around. So that's how you do all of those cool things within your 360 photo. Of course, you can paint stuff out that you don't want there. You can use the stamp tool, you can use the healing tool. Whatever you don't like about your photo, just remove it. If you want to see your photo as an equirectangular, you want to go down into the layers section and we're going to double click spherical map. This opens up a new file up here and this is our equirectangular. You'll see that the Photoshop logo is all skewed now. However, don't worry, it's going to look normal when we go back into 360 mode. But using this feature is going to be super handy when color correcting normal JPEGs, because this is what's going to allow us to color correct without getting that dreaded seam line. It's not an actual seam line from stitching. Rather, it's a seam line from color correction that's produced when you use too much saturation and you play with the contrast and color a bit too much. So if you're still getting the seam line, make sure you do your color corrections after you've changed to the spherical map. Once we're done looking at the spherical map, we can go ahead and close that and save, and that will save any changes we make to the original 360 photo we have. One thing you don't want to do from this point is go File Save As or File Export, because it's going to export just this single frame here, whereas we want to export it as a 360 panorama. The way you do that is going back up to our 3D menu, go Spherical Panorama and Export Panorama. And here we have our final photo. When we take it into a 360 viewer, it's going to display nicely. Everything is how it should be. All right, guys, I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the box below, but hopefully these few things will take your 360 photos to the next level, and they should definitely help you out with editing those RAW files. I like using Camera Raw personally. It's super easy to use, and you can use it right there inside of Photoshop. And that's 5 o'clock. The sun has gone completely down. I am disappearing with every second that passes. So on that note, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more awesome 360 photo and video tutorials. Follow me on Instagram here, Facebook here. Also, if you love your 360 photography, check out my ebook. It's called The Beginner's Guide to Tiny Planet Photography, and it'll teach you how to achieve every single tiny planet effect that you see on my Instagram. Check out the link down there and download it today. Until next time, be sure to capture your world in 360. I've got some awesome videos coming out really soon. I know you guys are going to love, and psst, I've got a video course coming out really soon. It's called A Beginner's Guide to 360 Video. I'm working on it now. This is what I should be doing instead of making this tutorial. A video course will be coming out in the next few weeks, and it'll cover everything you need to know about 360 video. And that's it. It's time I disappeared. Bye.